Now that we flashed the Qubes image to a USB stick, we can connect this USB stick to a computer and install Qubes as a main operating system on that computer. Or we can use another USB stick, flash Qubes to it, and then use Qubes as a live operating system using this second USB stick. So we'll be able to connect it to any computer we want, regardless of what operating system it runs, and then we'll be able to use Qubes. And when we're done, the computer that we used will be back to using its default operating system. Now, as I mentioned earlier, Qubes is a complex operating system. So, unlike the Tails USB, which we connect to pretty much any computer and boot into Tails, in order to boot Qubes image, we have to modify the BIOS settings of the computer that we're going to use. Entering the BIOS settings varies depending on the computer that you have and depending on the motherboard. On the right here, I have a table of the most common computers, along with the buttons that you need to press in order to enter the BIOS settings. So, as soon as you turn on the computer or restart it, you'll need to press the button relevant to your computer in here in order to enter the BIOS settings. Once you're there, you want to make sure you enable virtualization. In most cases, you'll also need to disable secure boot and set the boot to legacy. This is optional, but to my experience, I had to do that in a number of laptops. Then you can finally configure your boot order to boot from USB first, or you can just restart and enter the boot menu like I showed you before with Tails and choose to boot from USB. So let me show you how to do this on a real computer. Okay, so this is a Lenovo computer. Therefore, based on the table that I just showed you, I will need to press F2 as soon as I turn on this computer in order to enter into its BIOS settings. So first, I'm going to hit the power button to turn it on, and as it's being turned on, I'm going to keep pressing F2 to enter the settings. And perfect. As you can see, I am in the BIOS settings right now. Now keep in mind, depending on your computer, the settings might look different than what I have in here. The main thing that you want to keep in mind is to modify the four settings that I mentioned earlier. Enable virtualization, disable secure boot, enable legacy mode, and set it to boot from USB first. Like I said, you might find these settings under different categories or under different windows, but just make sure you modify these settings. So as you can see for me, the first window that I see is just an information window. It doesn't really allow me to modify anything. Now you can use the keyboard to navigate between these windows or these tabs. So I'm going to press the right arrow to go to the configuration window. And in here, the only thing that I want to modify is Intel virtualization technology. So I'm going to use the down arrow to navigate to that. And I'm going to hit enter to change the setting, press down to set it to enabled, and hit enter again to select it. Now, if you're not sure about how to use this interface, because like I said, you might actually get a different interface, keep an eye on the instructions that you see at the bottom, as they tell you exactly how to navigate and modify the settings. Now, I'm done with the configuration window. I'm going to press the right arrow again to go into the security tab. In here, again, we have another option that we want to change, which is secure boot. And like I said, this is optional. But in my experience, this can interfere with booting into Qubes and prevent you from installing Qubes. Therefore, I'm going to scroll down to secure boot. Again, hit enter to change the setting, change it to disabled, and hit enter again. We're done with this window. Now that these are two settings done, we have two to go. So we're going to press right to go to the boot window. And in here, as you can see, the first option is the boot mode. We want to change that from UFI to legacy. So again, I'm going to hit enter and select legacy. You might not get this, but as you can see, now I got an extra option here, the second one, the boot priority. It's set to UEFI first. Again, I'm going to hit enter and change that to legacy first. And finally, you don't even have to do this. I'm going to change the boot order so that it boots from USB first. You don't have to do this because you can exit this and just manually choose to boot from USB. I'm just going to do it here so that when I restart, I won't even have to enter the boot menu. So I'm just going to scroll down to the USB and I'll bring it all the way up. Again, I'm looking at the bottom of the BIOS screen to see how I can move items up and down. So based on that screen, it's telling me that I can use F5 and F6 to do so. Okay, now we're done with all the settings. So we enabled virtualization, we disabled secure boot, we disabled UEFI, and we set the boot to legacy, and we set it to boot from USB first. We're done with everything. We're going to go to the exit. So again, I'm going to press the right arrow again, and I'm going to select the first option, exit saving settings. It's going to ask me, do I really want to do this? I'm going to say yes. And before hitting enter, because once I hit enter, it's going to restart my computer, I'm going to connect the USB device that I flashed the Qubes ISO image to. I'm also going to connect a second USB device. This is the one that I showed you in green, and this is the one that I'm going to install Qubes to. So I'm not going to install it as a main operating system on this computer. I will install it just to this USB stick, so that I can use the second USB stick to run Qubes on any computer that can support Qubes. So I'm going to use it as a live operating system, similar to the way that we were using Tails. And now that we are ready to restart, I'm going to hit enter to save the changes and restart the computer. Now, as you can see, it automatically booted using the USB stick into the Qubes image that we flashed to our USB stick. If this didn't work for you, if it didn't boot automatically into this, then enter your boot settings as the system is starting, similar to what we did with Tails, and force it to boot from the USB stick that we flashed Qubes to. So now we're ready to go ahead and install Qubes, and I'll show you how to do that in details in the next lecture.